So what I want you to recognize here is that spiders are remarkably intuitive. Now this is Jack. Let's see, I wish I had a little bit longer extension here. Come on, just give me a little feel here. Give me a little feel with that little hand right there. There you go, it's all right, see? There you go, see? And he's a pretty kind of skitty little male. All right. Some people write that stuff off to a defensive response, and I can just tell you that it's not. We just really underestimate them overall. Come on, bud. Come on up. Come on up. There you go, right there. Come on up. Come on up. There you go, buddy. There you go, see? And these guys move incredibly fast. You know, they can probably run about the same speed we can. But as you can see, he gets that I'm not a threat. And their intuitive nature is just really surprising to me. Come on, buddy. Hi, you. Now, I don't see them as having the sort of adaptability that jumpers do. Come on, you give me this little finger right here? Come on. That's all right. It's okay. Just give me a little touch. A little tap. And I get that they have some sense, you know, I don't know if it's a sense of smell or whatever, but they have some sensory perception when they make contact with their little legs. Hi, bud. You're okay, see? You're okay, huh? And as you can see, he's not frightened of me. He recognizes that I'm not a threat in any way. Come on, give me just that little leg right there. There you go. There you go, see? There you go. That's right. That's right. And for those who would write that off to a defensive response, now if he were defensive, he'd be running away, and he'd probably have a bite reflex, and he has neither. So this is, you know, indicative of kind of how they respond when they recognize that you're pretty much, it's like a dog. Honestly, it's like a dog smelling the back of your hand, and they kind of know whether or not you're a threat. Hi, buddy. So this is my Wolfman Jack, my one wolf spider. And I got to tell you, I kind of regretted getting him at first because, I really didn't have a place for him, and I felt like he was gonna, you know, just not have the greatest life in the world, and yet we've been able to sort of bond here. Hi, buddy, come on up. Come on, give me those fingers. See, you're okay, huh? You're okay. And you see how big he is. They live quite a bit longer, from what I understand, than the jumpers, too. And again, you know, not quite as intuitive, not quite as interactive as the jumpers, but still pretty smart. And one of the things that really impresses me about this particular species is that there's not a lot of propensity for the females to eat the males, number one. And number two, the females keep their young with them. They nurture them for quite some time. They keep both the clutch on them. And then afterwards, they'll keep the babies on them for some time. And, I don't know, it says something about their character. Hi, buddy. Yeah, look at you, huh? Look at you.